This instructional video is to show you how to create a Glog poster on Glogster.com. Creating a Glog account is fairly simple. You just enter a username, an email address, and a password, and click Create Account. To create a Glogster account that is not associated with Glogster EDU, you must use an email address that does not end in .edu for your account. Alternatively, you can sign in using the Facebook Connect option here. You have a few options for creating a Glog. You can create a poster Glog, a wide Glog, or you can choose from one of the templates. For this example, I'm going to choose the Pinboard Glog template. As you can see in the top left corner, you have several options for the different types of media that you can add to a Glog. You can add text, graphics, images. You can edit the background or the wall. You can add audio, video, and data. To add images to your Glog, click any of the areas that say drop image, and you'll be presented with the gray icons on the side. To add an image, click the image icon and click image again here on the black bar. These are images that I have already added to Glogster. If you have other images that you want to add to Glogster, you just click upload. And then you select your images. And open your image. If you've associated your account with Facebook, you can click Facebook and it'll pull your images from Facebook. And you can do the same with Flickr, Picasa, or Google. Once you've uploaded your images, they'll appear in the My Images section. To drop an image onto your poster, click the image and click Use It. If you double-click on the image, you can add a frame by clicking Add Frame. And if you're using a template, you can change your frame. You can click and drag images. And if you find that one image is overlapping, you can choose to move it to the back using this icon or move it to the front. You can also copy images by using the copy icon. And if you've made a mistake, you can click the trash can to delete the image. If you're happy with the placement of an image and you don't want it to move, or you don't want to mistakenly delete it, you can lock the image using the lock icon. I'm going to go ahead and finish up adding my images. Okay, so I've added all the images that I want to my pinboard. Now let's look at text. To change the text on a text box, just double-click on it and change the text. You can change the color of your text. You can bold, underline, or italicize your text. Once you finish, you can just click the X. If you want to change the color of your text box, click the dropper tool and select a color from the color wheel. If you want to add any special effects, you can click the wand icon and you can edit your shadow. And you can also edit the transparency. I'm going to finish editing the rest of my text. So I finished editing all of my text, and I'm also going to add a video. If you've chosen a template with a video in it, you can just click on the drop video section, and you can tell it's a video because it says video here in the top left corner. To add a video, click video. And if you'd like, you can search YouTube if you already have a video available there on YouTube. You can upload a video by clicking upload. And any videos you've chosen will appear in your My Videos section. Once you've selected a video, you can also preview it here in the right corner by clicking this play button. And then click use it. Let's say I don't like the border that's on the video. I can click the video icon again, select players, and I can select a different player. If you don't want a border, under categories click basic and select the pink play button. Then click use it. Here you can see that the autoplay is on. If you don't want your video to play automatically, click the green settings button and turn off autoplay. You can also adjust the volume. Then click apply. To change the background, click tools in the top right corner and select wall. You can go to the gallery and choose from the patterns that they have available, or you can choose a solid color. And once you've made your selection, just click use it. Here at the top is where you can also add images and media that are not already provided for you in template form. So if I wanted to add another image without the borders, I could choose an image, click use it, and it will drop in the center of my Glog. I can exit, click on the image, and I can resize it using the arrows in the corners. And I can rotate it using the arrows on the sides of the picture. Okay, I've finished my Glog. So now I want to save it. You can edit the name of your Glog. Click Continue Saving. You can tag your Glog if you'd like. Make sure the privacy is set to public so students can view your Glog. Click Finish Saving again. And then you'll receive a link to your Glog. Click the Copy Link option. And now you're ready to post your Glog link in Blackboard. So log into Blackboard, select your course, and go to your discussion forum. Here we have a week one Introduce Yourself forum where we're going to post our Glog. Click Create Thread. And type in a subject for your thread. If you didn't already add a brief introduction to your Glog, you can add it here in the post. And then in order to post your link, highlight your text, select the hyperlink icon, which is the little globe, paste your link in the URL field, select Open Link in New Window, and click Submit. And then the text you've highlighted is linked. Click Submit again. And you've made your introduction post with a link to your Glog poster.